good morning, all kings, queens, all in the various categories of life in the land of Western Togoland, our country. I greet all of you in the name of the great God in heaven and in the names of the gods of the land that our fathers knew before anyone came. I greet all of you. I greet all men and women, the youth, boys, girls, up to the baby, the fetus, in the pregnant stomach of our women. The land is going to be there, so we pray for them. Now, I want to turn to all of the land that this speech, I pray it reaches everyone, all meaningful citizens from the northern end of our land to the southern sector. Nobody is left aside. I greet all of you. This greeting wants to take us a little back to the last year. We saw a few things which are worth remembering in history. The Western Togoland has seen a lot of problems historically. At the time of the beginning of our freedom issues, deaths came. I don't want us to remember those ones, but life. Many people went to prison. Many people went to court and were freed. But that of last year saw a larger number of all arrests. The most historical arrest was carried on in the year. I was arrested a number of times and put on air on a helicopter and flew above the nation. This is a blessing that I've gone up and I have seen above the land. Yes, if this happens, it means God is telling us that at the time of our freedom, at the time that we shall be free, we shall go up high and look other people down below us. How does this come? It will come through love, cooperation, appreciation of all others' activities in the land. I am extending this greeting specially to those friends, brothers, who are all leading groups, various groups, aimed at the freedom of this country. But I want to advise all that a united hand is the one that pushes the cart better. That now that we have reached a level of declaration, they all come back for us to speak with the same mouth, the same tongue, the same mind, so that people all over the world will see and know that these people are really brotherly. To be struggling for political affairs does not mean we should be fighting. We should be ill-minded about one another. I am inviting all of the various groups which are speaking of the freedom of Western Togoland in the land. If you wake up in the morning, go about your work successfully, do it well, so that if it demands promotion, you take it. If it demands finance, it reaches in your pocket. But when you waste your time thinking about what you do to the other person to fall, what shall I do to the other person to look mean in the face of the other of all other people, you are wasting your glory time. That time can be used for anything that will benefit us all better. So if you go to your base, pray, think of your friend's success before that of yours. That is godly enough. I turn around to salute all kings who have this matter in heart. Those of them who do not mind, so we cannot be independent, what we have. You cannot say, I don't have anything under the earth, underground, like minerals, like what and what. Therefore, my independence is not necessary. You are not the only poor nation in the world, but they are free. They are thinking. They are doing their own things themselves. Those chiefs, they call themselves, I call them kings. Those of them who have that mind, we don't have anything. We don't have to struggle for anything. Let us remain in the hands of the colonists. You are rather worse than good. There are some of them who have given out themselves and say, even if it means death, I will go. Those ones are good. But at the end of this year, many of them have changed their minds, have come to join me. The chiefs now behind me are more than 3/4 of those in the land. Yes, they are going to be 100%. I greet all of you in the name of the gods of the earth, gods of the land, God on the high heavens. We pray that this year brings the end of everything we are fighting. No doubt we shall take our independence. Thus I promise you fervently. Thank you very much for listening to me.